When you register an application, the system automatically creates the default application view with viewpoints bound to the application dimensions. This allows you to manage dimensions individually and export the dimension data back to the external application. Cross-dimensional intersections enable you to build validation rules across dimensions and extract the intersections to various downstream systems. You can achieve this by creating an unbound viewpoint within the same view. I've already registered an application and imported data. The default application view has four viewpoints that are bound to their dimensions. To maintain cross-dimensional intersections, I need to create a multi-segment maintenance viewpoint. The first step is to create a node type for the maintenance viewpoint and to define its properties. I've already created a node type named multi-segment. In the properties for the node type, notice that I've created custom properties for each dimension in the intersection. These are used to store the related dimensions' node names. To enforce validation of property values, each of these properties is configured with the node data type and is assigned to a node set that defines the corresponding dimension viewpoint. Each property is also configured for allowed node types within the assigned node set. You can add more properties to the multidimensional node type to satisfy the requirements of downstream systems. In this example, I've added the properties start date and end date. The name property must uniquely identify cross-dimensional intersections. One possible way to do that is to concatenate the dimension node names using a dash as a separator. This enables you to enter an intersection once and then let the system derive property values for the dimension nodes by using the split and get methods. For example, I set the default type for the account property to derived and then create an expression for its default value. The expression gets the first string in a string list created by splitting the node name at each dash character. After setting up the multidimensional node type, the next step is to create a node set for the maintenance viewpoint. For this example, I've created a node set as a list. However, because long lists might be hard to maintain and consume, you can organize intersections as a hierarchy to make it easier to search and find nodes. Now let's create the maintenance viewpoint. I'll choose the dimension that represents the first segment in the intersection and enter a name and description. Next, select a node set and save the viewpoint. The viewpoint is now active, and you can see the node type and the properties that were created earlier. Let's open the maintenance viewpoint and add a node that defines a cross-dimensional intersection. To make it easier to remember the format of the intersection, you can provide a custom label and description for the name property. For the XDIM segment's property value, enter a combination of node names, one for each dimension, separated by a dash. The system derives dimension nodes from the input and validates them against the respective dimension nodes. If the validation is successful, then the system assigns the default values for each property. If the validation fails, then the system displays an error message notifying you that the node name in the intersection is not a valid node in the dimension. You can also create a validation rule that checks whether the input has data for all segments. For example, if you enter fewer than four dimension nodes in the intersection, the system displays an error message that the intersection must have four segments. I've configured this validation rule in the multi-segment node type for the name property. The validation expression uses the split method to create a string list, and then uses the size method to check whether the list has four elements. I'll fix the intersection. Let's add another node. This time, I'll create an intersection with one or more dimensions undefined. Because I still need to have all segments, I'll use an asterisk to identify undefined dimensions. Since the product dimension does not have a node with the name asterisk, I've modified the default value expression for the product property to enforce this business rule. I've added a few more intersections and am ready to submit a request. Next, I'll export the intersections using an extract that I've already created. In this example, the extract consists of only the four properties that define the intersection. However, you can add other properties from the viewpoint, as well as constant values, to satisfy specific requirements of your downstream system. On the Options tab, you can specify file and data format of the extract. Let's run the extract. You can save the extract as a file to the local file system or to Oracle Object Storage via a defined global connection. I'll save the extract as a file. The extract file contains the intersections from the maintenance viewpoint. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.